bring you the Dunkirk girls and the home team, the Fredonia Lady Hillbillies. And tonight we have a contrasting story here, Mary Kate. We have Carol Zirkel, the mentor, and Sarah Bogardis, the outstanding basketball player and graduate of Fredonia High School, and now coaching at Dunkirk High School. And you know, she's coming home on her home turf, so to speak, and she's going to go against her coach for the first time this year. Well, we'll see what, you know, I was reading in the paper today that Carol Zirkel hasn't lost to Dunkirk since her tenure here at Fredonia. And I'm very impressed what they have done this year. They put together a lot of young talent. They're going to take the brunt of many, many losses throughout the season. But they realize that it's, you know, it's the program and it's for the good of the order. And, you know, this may be Dunkirk's night, given that fact that, you know, Dunkirk has some real good basketball players this year. And Sarah Bogardis has done an outstanding job with John Bogardis' assistant coach, her father. They've done an outstanding job putting a pretty competitive team on the court. You had the opportunity to coach with or play for Coach Zirkel. And I really appreciate her intensity level as a coach and the discipline she instills in her players. And I think Sarah is going to do the same for Dunkirk now. I think that, you know, they've got a program now. They've got a pretty good 7th and 8th grade coaching staff at Dunkirk. They have a very good coaching staff at Dunkirk, 7th and 8th grade. They have an excellent coach. And this is a voting call for Dunkirk in the basketball program as well. About a minute. How about this? Well, we'll wait for the starting lineup.
Welcome to Fredonia High School and Section 6 Athletics. Tonight's game is between the Dunkirk Lady Marauders and Fredonia Lady Hillbillies. In case of emergency, the emergency alarm will sound. We ask that you exit the building.
I'm not normally the play-by-play guy. We usually, you know, the veteran Ed Eaker, who's going
to
do the boys game. So this is a different gig for me. can help me, Mary Kate, and the coaching staff of Fredonia. From what I see over there, I see Brian Benchley, who's an assistant coach. I coached Brian in Forestville. I was the varsity basketball coach in Forestville. And I coached Brian Benchley as a varsity basketball player. And I'm not sure who the other gentleman is. Building mode this year, having several freshmen and sophomores on the team. A couple of seniors smattered in there, but I really, really like what Coach Circle's going to do. They're going to build that program up. And here we go at the start of the game.
What's nice is the freshmen are playing against the best players. Maybe it changes the caliber, but they're playing against the best players, improving every day.
Well, what I like too is, what I like about it is that they didn't waver from their tough non-league schedule.
Yeah,
they
definitely
played everybody tough this year.
Yeah, you know, the same schedule. Hard team in the non-league.
Cap goes to Thomas. Thomas loses the ball. And Morgan Genovese, a freshman, number 13, brings it up the court. Dunkirk in a zone. And the first foul of the game. Fouls on number 21, Elena Carlson. Dunkirk looks to Carlson for their rebounding strength. Dunkirk has a very, very solid rebounding team with Lacey Clark and Elena Carlson. Shot up, no good. And Clark with her first rebound. Joyce Pomasuto brings the ball up. Pomasuto's a junior. Dee Nance, Dunkirk's leading scorer. Bounce pass into Lacey Clark with a spin move up and in. Real nice entry pass by Dee Nance. Lacey Clark and a nice spin move, and Dunkirk has a lead 2-0. Dunkirk now in a man-to-man defense. Driving the ball is number 44, Krista Wheelock, and she's fouled by Tamika Thomas.
Dunkirk's playing aggressive.
That foul was on Clark. So both of Dunkirk's numbered, their rebounders have one foul each in the first minute of play. Dee Nance battles for the ball. She's driving. Back out to Bamasuto. That's a traveling violation. Good defense by Genovese getting back. Bamasuto had a shot. Genovese went in the lane and closed it off. Nance guarding number two, that's Morgan Genovese. Nance with a steal, up and in. The Dunkirk pressure is way up top. Nice left-handed drive by Genovese. Very nice. Missed. Nance with the rebound. Brings it up. Fredonia also playing man-to-man. Nice entry pass to Clark, and she puts it in with the left hand. Nice driving layup by Clark. And Fredonia takes a timeout with 6:09 remaining in the first quarter. Dunkirk jumps out to a 6-0 lead. As we mentioned before the game, this is probably Dunkirk's best opportunity over the years that Carol Zirkel has coached. She's undefeated against Dunkirk. And, this could be the night. Just given the fact of the experience, and the for no other reason.
Definitely.
Of course, Fredonia, you know, without Aiden Geis, you know, I thought for sure over the years watching Aiden as a freshman and a sophomore that she would be a 1,000-point scorer by the end of her career. And unfortunately, a couple of knee surgeries and problems. What a super athlete and a great kid, you know, and just a disappointing, disheartening thing for a young lady, especially the caliber of her. I thought that she would be one of the premier players in Western New York this year. And Fredonia could have built on that.
Yeah, definitely. She was a playmaker, and she also was very smart.
So Dunkirk goes back into a 2-3 zone now after the timeout. That's a good coaching decision on Bogardus' part. And there's a steal, and back over to number 13, Rachel Smith. There's a turnover, and the ball's bounced around quite a bit. Number 44 goes up with a shot. And that's Krista Wheelock. Goes up for a shot, much to the crowd's dismay. That's a two-shot foul for Krista Wheelock. Yeah, that's the second foul for number 22, Lacey Clark. So early in the game, 5:45 remaining in the first quarter, Lacey Clark picks up her second foul.
She's a key rebounder, too, for Dunkirk. That might be a down call for them.
Krista Wheelock bounces the first one in for Fredonia's first point of the game. Second shot up off the rim. Gets her own rebound. Nice putback. No good. And Key Nance comes down with a rebound. Looks like her third of the game so far. Tomasuto with the ball over to Carlson. Carlson with a drive. No good. Rebound. But step out of bounds. Michelle Naparella.
Naparella is a very aggressive player. Dunkirk posts a hard time down there.
And Dunkirk turns it over. Several turnovers to start this game. Rachel Smith brings the ball up. And there's Genovese with a left-handed shot. No good. And Carlson with the rebound. Over to Nance. Nance brings it up. To Bamasudo. Couple of dribbles over to Thomas. Thomas with a long shot, up no good. Nice box out by number 33. Tarnowski, but that's off her hands and out of bounds, Dunkirk ball. Carlson over to Bamasudo. The put back to Nance. Shot off the rim, no good. Thomas with a nice rebound. You gotta like Fredonia's aggressiveness defensively so far. Dunkirk hasn't penetrated much at all.
It's good. Fredonia's gotta get a hand in their face if they wanna compete.
Shot by number 24, and she gets her own rebound. No boxing out by the Lady Marauders. Off and no good. And another rebound, and that's three consecutive putback and shots by Michelle Naparella. And you called it, Mary Kate. Very aggressive player. She took a shot, got a rebound, took another one, got a rebound, took it, and put it up. Thomas with a shot, no good. Game a little aggressive, and we have a foul on, as you called it, Naparella. With an aggressive move, shoving someone out of bounds. Nothing wrong with a little aggressiveness.
Can I say she likes the ball, she wants it.
6-3, Dunkirk, 4:10 remaining in the first quarter. Nance up with a shot, no good, and the rebound comes down to Tarnowski. Wheelock brings the ball up to Genovese. And a shot from Rachel Smith, no good. Dunkirk battling for the boards with Krista Wheelock and Key Nance battling. There's a tie up and it's Fredonia's ball on possession arrow.
Now Wheelock is a young freshman, but she's ready to learn and she works hard too.
Yeah. turnover on Fredonia. Fredonia's gonna press a little. We'll see how Dunker can handle it. They gotta pick up everybody though, and Thomas broke free and was open. It's a good idea by Coach Zirkel to go to a press and challenge Dunker at this time, challenge them to, you know, put the ball up the floor if they can't do it, if they have trouble.
Yes, and a press is also a good thing to get the shot clock lower. So when they get the ball, they get a smaller chance to score.
Very aggressive defense on Fredonia, playing way up top. Genovese picks up another foul. That's both teams have three personal fouls. Fredonia's gonna battle. It's not gonna be a cakewalk by the Lady Marauders this evening. Bamasuto goes deep into the corner and another foul. The foul is on number 10, Emily Velvo. Another freshman comes into the game. Nance with the ball. And you know, Naparella right in her face. Right in her face, and Nance threw the ball out of bounds.
She's not afraid to get on the floor. She's a very aggressive player.
Dunkirk in a 2-3 zone. Smith over to Genovese. Double team. Good cross-court pass. Back over to Smith. Smith looking, back over to Genovese. Drives to the basket. Good defense by Nance, cutting off the baseline. Entry pass into Naparella. Real nice entry pass by Genovese over to Naparella, and the score is 6-5 with 3 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Well, that's Naparella's second, I believe. So Fredonia's gonna use up all their fouls early. Put Dunkirk to the line. It's the second foul on Naparella. That was a real nice entry pass by Genovese. Dunkirk took a 6-0 lead to start the game, and Fredonia's gone on a 5-0 run. Valvo with a nice play. Aggressive out of bounds. Tried to steal it. Dunkirk's ball.
That is one thing Carol Zirkel tells her players, is you've got to keep it to every ball. If there's a 50-50 ball, you get it.
There's a shot by number 14, Selenia Ruiz, off the mark.
He Nance does a wonderful job driving to the basket and knowing to dish out for the open shot, something that she has very good court awareness.
I think what you'll see as the course of the game goes on, she'll start shooting a few more of those, though.
Yeah.
There's a shot by Rachel Smith, looking for the lead on Fredonia's part, up and no good off the backboard and out of bounds. Now into the game, number 20, Bree Don, another freshman. Into the game for the Lady Marauders, Joyce Bamasuto's back in, and number 10, Jessica Gifford. Nance with the ball, breaking the press with ease. She's gonna take it down all the way and off the rim and no good. Rebound by Velvo. Velvo bringing it up with a nice pass. Oh, that's an offensive foul on number 45, Hannah Gilray. Good thought, but and a real nice pass by Velvo, but Gilray got a little bit rambunctious and with an offensive foul and an elbow. That's Fredonia's 16th foul. Dunker could be shooting foul shots early.
Yeah, they'll definitely have to bear it on next quarter if they want to.
When I'm watching this game right now and how Dunkirk's beating the press, they're screening for nobody.
Yeah.
So the girls have to use their own individual talent to get open instead of setting screen. See, now Key has to be the player to get the ball. She's got to do everything. Carlson with an up and a flip shot, no good, and Velvo with the rebound. There's a shot by number 22, Alice Moore, and Fredonia. That's a three-pointer, and Fredonia takes an 8-6 lead. So after a 6-0 start by the Lady Marauders, Fredonia comes roaring back with some very, very aggressive defense, and they take an 8-6 lead on a 3-pointer by Alice Moore.
Emily Valvo picks up her second foul, team 7th. They're going to be in 1-1 for the next rest of this quarter and next quarter.
Well, and that will be the key for the Lady Marauders on whether or not they can hit a couple of foul shots. They haven't scored since the 4-minute mark. Probably the first 2 minutes of the game. They were ahead 6-0. Massenet with a 1-1 attempt off the rim. Key Nance with the rebound, and now you'll see Nance go to the line. Key Nance, one of the league's leading scorers this year. I must say, it's real nice to get someone who's been in Carol Zirkel's circle of players to get an idea of exactly what goes on over there on the bench and what she's looking for from a coach. And I appreciate that when you're telling us what is going on out here for the Fredonia Lady Hillbillies. Nance puts the second foul shot in. It's 8-7. Dunkirk going back to a man-to-man defense. Genovese, left-hander, guarded by Nance, almost loses it. Up with the ball. His number 45, I believe.
Yeah, Hannah Gilray.
That would be Hannah Gilray, a senior, puts it in for a 10-7 lead for the Lady Hillbillies. Nance gonna put up a shot, no good. Selena Ruiz tracking down the rebound. And number 50 also hustling in there, Sarah Kruver was hustling, and she tapped it out of bounds. Very, very aggressive defense by the Lady Hillbillies, and Dunkirk's having a hard time with it. The fact that Lacey Clark picked up 2 fouls early makes a difference too. Shot by Nance, no good.
One of their leading rebounders is probably tough for Dunkirk to get used to not having her in the game.
There's a shot by Genovese, no good. Rebound again by Fredonia. Number 22 makes a real nice play, Alice Moore. Now, is that of Moore descent of Coach Moore and the rest of the Moore family in Fredonia?
Looks like it.
Okay. And like Grace, she likes to shoot?
Yeah,
okay.
She does. She has a nice shot as well.
Yes,
Grace.
She does.
I just saw Grace, actually. She's here supporting her sister.
Very good. Grace was an outstanding player. Good shooter for Fredonia. So Moore puts 1 foul shot in, 11-7. And the second shot up and in off the rim. And good. 12-7 lead. Fredonia's on a 12-1 run. A lot of one-on-one play by the Lady Marauders. They don't have a man-to-man offense right now.
I understand these Fredonia girls want to be aggressive, but there's a fine line between being aggressive and being silly with these fouls.
Yeah, but it seems to be working.
Yeah. That's true. We'll see in the second half, though, when they're shooting every time.
And what will happen now, Mary-Kate, is there's 9 fouls, so they won't need the one-on-one bonus. They will just get the 2 shots for the remainder. You know, I mean, 1 more foul, they'll get it for the next 7 minutes of the game. And shooting 2 is a lot easier than shooting 1-on-1s.
We also have 3 girls for Fredonia in foul trouble as well, so that'll put them on the bench. And with Dunkirk, we have 2 on Clark.
Nance puts the first one in. Second one up and good. Very good foul shooter. 12-9, 54 seconds remaining, first quarter. Well, good attempt by Smith to get the ball down low to Krista Wheelock. See, now Dunkirk right here, this is all Nance trying to get open. Well, they're just, Fredonia's not gonna play it. Little foul trouble. Damari Masonette with the ball, dribbling right. Looking for somebody, no screens. Tamika Thomas with the ball, with a bounce pass over to Nance. Back over to Thomas. Here's Damari Masonette. Bassinette drives. Nice pass.
Very nice pass.
Prettiest pass of the night. And that was on the hands of Damari Massanet to Keen Ants, giving Fredonia still a one-point lead with 10 seconds remaining in the quarter. Nance with a steal, and she's got to look at the shot clock here. There's 3, 2, 1. She doesn't identify. She shoots, and oh, almost good at the buzzer. Well, a real spirited first quarter, especially in my mind by the Lady Hillbillies, coming out and really playing aggressive after trailing 6-0, putting a little man-to-man press on, and you know, making a real good 12-1 run. But Dunkirk comes back and scores the last 4 points of the quarter to lead, to have Fredonia's lead cut down to 12-11. How about the scorers, Mary Beth or Mary Kate?
We have only two scorers for Dunkirk. We have Lacey Clark with 4 and Key Nance with, it looks to be, 7. For Fredonia, we have Alice Moore with 5, Michelle Neperell with 2, Hannah Gillay with 2, and Krista Wheelock with 1.
Well, I like Fredonia's aggressiveness off the offensive glass, too. But with Lacey Clark picking up 2 fouls in the first 3 minutes of the game, that really helped Fredonia, you know, crash the board, so to speak.
Yeah.
Especially when Naparella went in, shot, got her own rebound, shot, got her own rebound again.
She's very good. She knows where to be in good position.
So let's see what Dunkirk does to counter that. Let's see if how long Lacey Clark will sit out. Elena Clark Carlson didn't have too many rebounds in that quarter either, but she's going to be out here again. So Clark is coming out. So you have Dunkirk starting 5, Tamika Thomas, Elena Carlson, Lacey Clark, Joyce Bamasuto, and the leading scorer, Key Nance. For Fredonia on the court, you have Rachel Smith, Krista Wheelock, Alice Moore, Olivia Pucciarelli, and Hannah Gilray. So actually, I think there's 3 seniors out there, if I'm not mistaken, for Fredonia in a quick glance.
Yeah, there is.
So there's the 10th foul. So for 7:49 now, Dunkirk is going to shoot 2 foul shots. And that ties the game at 12-12.
Dunkirk is 4-for-5 on their foul shots. It's just keeping this game close.
And Dunkirk takes a lead after they were ahead 6-0. Fredonia went ahead 8-6. Dunkirk regains the lead 13-12. Well, a little travel, but a nice entry pass off the hands of 22, Alice Moore, but a travel. We'll see if Fredonia keeps the pace up with a man-to-man defense. Now they're calling it off. Bamasuto with the ball, bringing it up. Dunkirk running an offense. Tamika Thomas with the ball, driving the lane.
The great thing about Key Nance is she's so versatile. You can have her at the point guard, you can have her as a shooting guard, and you can also have her down low posting someone up.
You're right.
She's a triple threat.
There's Nance, as you spoke, right in the paint. She turns around with a 12-footer, no good, off the rim. And out on Elena Carlson. Ball on top, Smith stops her dribble. Not a good idea at half court. The ball stolen, taken away by Lacey Clark. Over to Tamika Thomas with a one-hander. From the foul line extended, about 17 feet, she puts it in. Tamika Thomas for 2. Dunkirk with a 15-12 lead, 6:35 remaining, second quarter. Thomas just a sophomore. Dunkirk has 1 senior on the floor. I don't know if you know this, Mary Kate, but these young ladies out here, the junior class and lower, I had the privilege of coaching them in modified basketball.
Did you?
Yes, I did. And now we have Mary Schneider and Gretchen Widener are the 7th and 8th grade coaches. I gave it up, but I had Joyce and those girls and Selena and and all those Key Nance and everything. They were very, very successful in the 7th and 8th grade. And Key's been on the varsity since her freshman year.
I think I played against her. I remember she was just starting off. I remember she was going to be a good player. I remember when she was a freshman that this girl's going to cause some problems for the league.
We've, like I said, Mary Schneider is a phys ed teacher and Gretchen Widener, an art teacher in the middle school, and they've done an excellent job with our girls at the modified basketball level. And of course, John Bogardis now lends some stability to the JV program.
Yeah.
And he'll do exactly what his daughter wants him to do.
And that's so important too, to have good coaches at a young age, because when they come to varsity, they don't have to learn anymore. They can just
They
play. Go out and play.
A little continuity.
Yeah.
Well, Dunkirk has made a nice recovery here. And Fredonia's in a little bit of foul trouble. So the score is 15-12, the Lady Marauders, 6:17 remaining. And Krista Wheelock bringing the ball up. Over to Smith. Smith is over to Sarah Kruber.
Up her first foul.
And that is a foul on Nance. Yep, their fifth. There's a shot by number 44, Krista Wheelock, who was chasing down the rebound, was Carlson, and Key Nance with the ball. Nance over to Thomas. She made a jumper before. She throws it up, no good. And the rebound comes down to number 33, Bailey Tarnowski. Smith driving left, picks up her dribble. Tarnowski with the ball, loses it to Carlson, an aggressive play by Carlson. However, they felt that was a travel. Pat Tyler, the referee down low, calls it a travel. I've had the pleasure of Pat Tyler calling a technical on me during my time as varsity coach. Entry pass tipped by Dunkirk. Stolen there, and Nance looking up and driving. Here she goes to the lane, and she dribbles it out of bounds.
That was smart defense by Morgan Genovese, not reaching, just having the girl.
I thought Key had Tamika Thomas down low and missed her. So Dunkirk playing man-to-man. Wheelock with the ball. She gives it up to Smith again. Smith makes a cross-court dangerous pass, and it's stolen by Key Nance. One of many that she's had already.
Yeah, Dunker does a very good job of reading that cross-court pass. They see him going to throw it, and they steal it.
Tomasuto Carlson. Carlson with a jump shot, no good. And the rebound comes down to Hannah Gilray. Smith again with the ball. To Kruver. And Smith going to take one. Three-pointer, no good. Run down by Carlson over to Bamasuto. Thomas with the ball. Bounce pass, nice spin move by Key Nance. She got the ball down on the block, made a nice sharp move with her left hand and went back up with her right for a deuce. Key Nance gives Dunkirk a 17-12 lead with 4:17 remaining in the second quarter. Oh, head fake, nice move by Rachel Smith. She got Bamasuto off her feet. Secondary defense came over. And that would be Elena Carlson picking up, I believe, which is her second foul. Two shots for Rachel Smith, senior point guard. First shot up and in. Substitutions into the game. Number 34, Olivia Bongiovanni.
Pucciarelli.
Pucciarelli Bongiovanni.
Both Italian.
They both end in an I. So Rachel Smith takes both of those shots and gives Fredonia, closing in on the margin, at 17-14. And that's a timeout. How the foul situation? That's calmed down, Mary Kate.
Yes, it has.
Fredonia does not have a foul this quarter. Oh, well, yeah, they have one foul.
They had one on Alice Moore, but we have two for Morgan Genovese, two on Michelle Nebrella, and two for Emily Available. A couple with one. And for Dunkirk, both Clark and Carlson have two. With Keenance with one. Dunkirk needs to keep under control their fouls, or there's going to be a 1-1 next basket.
Yep. And both teams will be in the bonus. So Morgan Genovese into the game, guarding Joyce Bamasuto. Genovese, freshman star, played as an eighth grader, I believe. Nice move by Carlson off the rim, no good. Rebound by Clark. Bounce pass is off a hand, and here comes Morgan Genovese. Ball rattled around on the mid-court line, and here comes Rachel Smith with another senior move, and she misses the layup. Good take by Rachel Smith. I'll carry him off the rim and out of bounds. So Pucciarelli in the game, Genovese, Smith, Naparella, and Wheelock for Fredonia. Dunkirk remaining with their starting five on the court. Good drive by Lacey Clark, double dribble. We couldn't see that from our angle. Nice entry pass to Pucciarelli, up and no good. Just a hustle rebound play by Elena Carlson. Nice pass by Nance over to Thomas. She got her feet right but didn't hit the rim. Good hustle rebound by Clark again, and there's Key Nance. Up and no good. Yes, a real nice pass by Lacey Clark. Unusual that Nance would miss that shot so close to the basket.
One of those in and out plays.
Into the game now for Fredonia is number 10, Emily Velvo. Looks like Joyce Bamasuto with the ball. Good move by Carlson, up and no good. This is gonna hurt.
That looked more like just a loose ball everyone was going for.
Yeah, you had three or four girls jumping straight up in the air.
Definitely.
But that is Lacey Clark's third foul. Selena Ruiz will replace her. And Michelle Naparella will go to the line and shoot the 1-1.
Fredoni's only scored 2 points this quarter. Hopefully Naparella can make it four.
Not much on the Marauder part either, correct?
No, there's 6 points for a Dunkirk.
6 points. Naparella's shot up off the front of the rim, off the backboard, and in. Nice rebound by Nance off the foul shot. 17-15, 2:33 remaining, second quarter. Dunkirk leads. Selena Ruiz with a nice spin move, and she's gonna go to the basket and shoot two. Well, I don't wanna jinx her, but I thought she was one of my better foul shooters when I raised her in eighth grade. We'll see. I think a lot of lefties wear number 14.
Really?
How about that? So Ruiz puts the first shot in, 18-15. Second shot up and in. Nothing but the bottom of the net. 19-15, 2:25 remaining, second quarter. Smith with the ball, over to Genovese. Genovese with a bounce pass, entry pass. to number 45, Hannah Gilray, and a nice shot right at the foul line. Real nice pass by Genovese, a bounce entry pass. Nice assist. There's Bamasuto with the ball. Elena Carlson from about 15 in the corner, no good. Tracked down by Rachel Smith, and here she comes. She's gonna drive to the basket. That's gotta be an offensive foul. She actually put her shoulder and elbow down, and but Rachel Smith got the call on a block.
It's one of those tough calls, you know. Those calls can always go both ways with the defense's feet planted, you never know. Sometimes it's better just not to call anything.
Well, sometimes it's better to hear one side scream and foul than both sides.
Very true.
The crowd could get ugly.
Yes, especially Dunkirk-Fredonia games, I remember.
19-18, another good foul shot by Rachel Smith. She's had a real nice game tonight. And another one rolls it in.
She's 4 for 4 in her foul shot.
Yes, yes, she
is.
Very
good leadership right there.
19-19. Nance to Masonette. Masonette puts it up and in. Giving Dunkirk a 21-19 lead. 1:35 left, second quarter. Smith gives it over to Alice Moore. Alice Moore misses, and Masonette with the rebound. Oh, double team. Nance is double team. Bamasuto puts the ball up. Just short.
Misses it and then creates a foul.
That's a frustration foul on Joyce's part.
Alice is 2 for 2 so far in her foul shots.
That's Bamasuto's second foul. First shot up, no good on the 1-1. Thomas with a rebound. To Nance. Bounce pass off Bamasuto. She hustles it back down.
Fans are getting a little aggressive so far.
Always a good time for the officials during a Dunkirk-Fredonia outing.
They look forward to it.
Nice head fake and drive by Hannah Gilray, no
Gets
good.
Her own rebound.
Gets her own rebound, no boxing out. Puts it back up, no good. Another rebound by Lady Hillbillies, 22 got that rebound more. And Gilray gets the other rebound, dribbles out of bounds. Very, very aggressive play by Moore and Gilray. On the offensive glass, the two seniors relentless off the board. Masonette gonna play a little point guard. Gonna put Key Nance down on the foul line. Nance with the ball. She spins, she shoots. Nice play. Excellent play. Dunkirk identified it. Masonette can play a little point. 23-19, 30 seconds remaining. There's a shot by Ellis Moore. Good, no good. Pucciarelli rattles the rebound down. And there's Rachel Smith. She puts it up, no good. And it's Fredonia's ball. Again, the offensive rebounding by Fredonia has kept them in this first half of basketball. Oh, good entry pass, nice play. Pucciarelli up, no good. And she'll go to the line. The interior defense by the Lady Vermont Marauders missing at this point in time Elena Carlson and Lacey Clark has caused problems for Dunkirk. They have no interior defense. They're not getting any rebounds. So Pucciarelli's going to shoot. She's going to get two here. That one's up and good. And if I remember, this young lady was a Knights of Columbus foul shooting champion. Right?
Yeah, I think she was actually.
Yeah. Good form off the basket, no good. And out of bounds on Fredonia. 14.3 remaining. Take a look at the clock. I'd give it right back to Masonette. But Looks like Nance going to bring it up. And that looks like a, oh, that's a jump ball. No possession, but there's a jump. 7.5 remaining. Fredonia probably working for the last shot. Dunkirk doesn't need to foul, put anybody at the line. There's Smith driving the basket. She goes up and she's fouled, and the basket is good. A driving layup by senior Rachel Smith. That foul looks like it's on Keen Nance, her second. And that, if Rachel Smith makes this foul shot, that ties the game. 1.2 remaining. The score right now, 23-22. An outstanding drive by Rachel Smith, and she drove, and Keen Nance got the foul. And that foul shot is up and good. So we are tied at the half. We are tied at 23 all. Mary Kate, I think clearly when Lacey Clark and Elena Carlson are out of the game, there's a huge discrepancy in the aggressiveness off the offensive boards for Fredonia, and they took total advantage of it. As you had mentioned late in the second quarter, Fredonia had only 2 points.
Yeah.
And they scored 8 points, and that they went on an 8-4 run and tied this score up at 23-23 when we come into the second half. So Dunkirk's got to shore the defense up without their two big rebounders in the game. And if they don't, they're in for a long night.
Yes. It's a big advantage when Carlson and Clark aren't in the game because they're their go-to rebounders, and Fredonia took advantage of that and got him any offensive rebounds.
Well, Rachel Smith was driving to the basket, and there's no interior defense.
Definitely.
So, you know, there's a lot of positive things going on for Fredonia. I don't believe they've won a game this season. And this could be I personally maybe would have to consider this sort of kind of an upset given the records. I mean, but as we've mentioned before, a Dunkirk-Fredonia game, you throw the records out the door.
Definitely.
Because you never know what can
happen.
And this is an obvious sign of what we're talking about when it comes to Dunkirk-Fredonia.
Yes, definitely. When I, coming into any Dunkirk-Fredonia game, I felt like we were always the go-ahead, but it didn't matter. We knew coming in it was going to be a hard-fought battle, and that's what both teams are doing. And I think Fredonia knows that this is one of their biggest games of the season, and they're doing a great job, and so is Dunkirk. I think if they just both bear down a little bit, it'll be a great second half.
When we talked about the foul trouble early, you know, Fredonia had 10 fouls with 7:49 remaining in the first half. Going into the second quarter, 7:49 remaining. But the foul trouble is based on who has those fouls,
yes,
too.
Mm-hmm,
you know, when you're talking about the fouls of six or seven young gals as opposed to Dunkirk's Lacey Clark, who has 3 of Dunkirk's 10 fouls, and Elena Carlson, who has 2 of them. I mean, they're sharing the wealth of the fouls, and those are their 2 better players.
Leading scorers for Dunkirk are Key Nance with 11 and Lacey Clark with 2. We have Carlson, Massenet, and Thomas, and Ruiz with 2. For Fredonia, we have Rachel Smith with 7, all in the second quarter. Michelle Neparella with 5, Gilroy with 4, Cucciarelli with 2, and Alice Moore with 5.
And Rachel Smith, again, 5 consecutive foul shots.
That's very good.
A 3-point play to end the second half,
yeah,
or to end the second quarter, giving Fredonia that 23-23 tie. And that's where we stand, and we'll be back with the exciting second half from the Fredonia Gymnasium. Again, the score, Dunkirk 23 and the home court Lady Marauders 23. Well, you know, that's what the top commentators of sports do. Mm-hmm. They come late, they show up when they want, they pick the games they want to do. Well, this ought to be a real good second half. We'll see how many adjustments. You know, I mean, I don't think Fredonia has to adjust at all. I think they had an excellent game plan.
Uh-huh.
They went out and burned a lot of fouls early, and they forced Dunkirk into a lot of early turnovers with their man-to-man defense. They didn't care how much they pounded it, and they played good defense and frustrated Dunkirk. You know, Dunkirk worked real hard for their baskets. And then Fredonia, you know, went to the offensive glass so many times that there were several fouls on the Lady Marauders, including two key fouls, or two key players in Carlson and Lacey Clark. So I think Fredonia has played what they would consider probably a perfect first half for them.
Yes.
And Dunkirk, being what they probably felt as when they walked in here as a favorite tonight, is a little bit flustered.
It's a hard atmosphere coming to this game as the away team. I remember going into Dunkirk being a little intimidated. So maybe Dunkirk will bear down and hopefully the nerves are out of the way.
Well, I'd like to see Kay Nance be a little bit more assertive offensively. I think she's, although she does have, what's she got?
11
points. I think,
it's a shy 11.
It's not her. I mean, two of her shots were when she was posting down low and not driving to the basket herself. She was receiving the ball. I'd like to see a little bit more of Damari Masonette come in too, because she can play the point. If they're gonna put Nance on the block,
yeah,
she can play the point. There it is, Nance with a very aggressive move to the basket. And just as we spoke, Mary Kate, she was aggressive to the basket, and she goes right through the Fredonia defense, giving Dunkirk a 25-23 lead to start the second half. There's a foul on Elena Carlson.
That's her third.
So Dunkirk, Coach Sarah Bogardis, is going to have some type of strategy here the second half, who she's going to play. She's going to play one of her stars or play them both at the same time. That shot by Naparella, no good. And in comes Selena Ruiz for Carlson. So they're going to stick with Lacey Clark and play one of the girls with three fouls at a time. That shot is up and good by Naparella, 25-24. Nance being guarded by Smith, Bongiovanni by Genovese. Thomas being guarded by Krista Wheelock. Thomas has a shot, and it's good. A big shot by Tamika Thomas. She needs to hit those.
And she sets her feet. She has a very nice shot.
Nice three-pointer by Tamika. Ball on the floor. Genovese drives. Looked like a foul on Nance, no call. And an aggressive rebound by Lacey Clark as we talk. So right there, Mary Kate, she was aggressive off the boards, surrounded by two Fredonia gals, and a foul ensued. That's Naparella's third foul. So actually, Naparella getting in foul trouble could be trouble for Fredonia.
Yeah, she was in foul trouble the first half. Hopefully the second half she won't be.
There's a rebound and an outlet pass by Naparella, taken by Nance. And Nance aggressively going to the basket. Here comes Bamasuto for a three, off the rim, no good. That ball's out of bounds off of Selena Ruiz. Both girls hustling, Smith and Ruiz. Ball going out on Ruiz. Naparella's out of the game now. Replaced by number 33, Bailey Tarnowski. There's another steal by Nance. I can't count how many she has tonight. Tamika Thomas gonna shoot, no good. That's a block, that's a good block. There's Selena Ruiz, gives the ball to Bamasuto.
Morgan needs to do a better job of
sliding
of
her feet.
It's a freshman mistake right there, trying to play defense with her hands.
Very good observation, Mary Kate. And a lot of that is freshman immaturity on the floor and not being ready and anticipating what another player would do and beating them to the spot.
I know Carol Zirkle right now probably is taking her out to talk to her about it right now.
That's Genovese's third foul. Tamika Thomas with a running shot off the glass and in. That is a huge basket. If I mean, if you really put it into perspective,
yeah.
That's a huge basket right there, because that's one that probably doesn't normally go in. So Tamika Thomas, with her last 5 points of dunkers, gives them a 30-24 lead, 6:01 remaining in the third quarter.
Setting a little spark for Dunkirk's offense.
Well, they need more offense. I mean, they need to hunker down on defense, but they need some offensive threats other than Keenan's. We'll see how much Fredonia is affected. Now, they're two of their starters, Naparella and Genovese, are now out with three fouls. And those gals have been seasoned to play a lot of minutes.
Yeah.
Assistant coach Brian Benchley looking over the foul situation. Inbounding the ball will be Alice Moore. One senior to another, Rachel Smith. Over to Krista Wheelock, and the jump shot is no good, and here comes Tamika Thomas. Aggressive play again. Oh, and if that goes in.
Looks like it hit the top.
Yeah, that probably shouldn't have counted to begin with. That foul, I believe, is on Olivia Pucciarelli. And it is. And right away, three fouls, 5:45. So in 2 minutes, 15 seconds, the pace continues for Fredonia. So Tamika Thomas has the last 5 points for Dunker. She's been the offensive spark. The score was 23-23 at the half. First shot up, no good. Tamika averaged about 10-11 points during her eighth grade time. When she moved up last year and played 1 year at JV's, now as a sophomore, she's on the varsity. There might be a discrepancy in the fouls.
I had one on Olivia Pucciarelli in my book, so I wonder.
I think they're looking toward the other gals. I think
the
ones like Genovese and Naparella. I always give me a minus one factor doing the book and talking at the same time. Mm-hmm. It's not easy.
It's very difficult, that's for sure.
You know, these guys on TV, they got six statisticians feeding them information. They can say whatever they want. They got all of it on a screen, and you know.
Just got my pencil and eraser, so.
That's why I don't know how Coach Eaker's done this for so many years. He's just, what a guy for the community. He's done this. God, got to be 25, 30 years of doing Access 12 and Access 19 TV. And he cares about the kids. He cares about getting it on the air and getting exposure for all the high school kids in the area.
Such a great thing for people who don't want to leave their house either.
Well, that's
you
true.
Get to come and watch the game.
You get a lot of different people who can't do that.
Yeah, definitely.
Who can't get out. I know that right now my Aunt Mary Gallardo, who I always say hi to, is down at Absolute, in Dunkirk, and I told her to watch the game tonight, and she's at Absolute. She'll be going home Sunday, actually. She's leaving. So she'll be starting a little bit of rehab at home and trying to make her way to recovery. And that shot by Thomas, that's her sixth straight point and a 7-point lead by Dunkirk. Now that's a... There goes Carlson, just standing there. And that's her fourth foul.
Dunkirk fans aren't very happy about that call.
Well, she was just standing there, and the ball was in both girls' hands.
They called a couple of those.
We saw a jump ball that was right here. That wasn't a jump ball. It was bouncing around. So.
Refs aren't perfect, as much as we'd like for them to believe they are.
We'd like a little bit more consistency, though. So that foul on a drive by Joyce Bamasuto is made by Olivia Pucciarelli. And here comes the mentor of our broadcasting crew, Mr. Ed Eaker. Bamasuto shot up and good. And a timeout. With 5:31 remaining in the third quarter, the Lady Marauders have opened up a 9-1 run to start the third quarter, and they have a 32-24 lead.
Greatest shots. I think they just need to bear down, use their shot clock. And Dunkirk's doing a great job pressuring.
Well, in the beginning of the game, like you just said, their aggressiveness defensively has dissipated just a touch. But the game plan was to really harass the Lady Marauders early, and it really, really worked. And they got back into the game because of that aggressiveness. Bamasuto shooting the second of two shots. It's up and good. 33-24. Dunkirk has no choice here, Mary Kate. They're now in a zone. Now you got to watch for Fredonia to bury the middle into the paint. Shot up and good by number 20, Bree Don, a freshman coming in and getting her first crack at offense, and she puts it in. Bamasuto driving behind the basket, no good. Ruiz with a nice rebound and a pass to Keenan, and she calmly puts that jumper in from the foul line.
Beautiful shot.
A lot of confidence in her stroke. There's a nice drive by Rachel Smith. She's going to answer back, and she does. And Lacey Clark couldn't play any defense. She didn't want to pick up a foul.
Definitely.
And Rachel Smith knew that and attacked her right away. Went right at Lacey Clark. Got the putback rebound for a basket. Tamika Thomas, pass a little low. She's not ready for it, and a turnover by Dunker. 7-point lead for the Lady Marauders. Might be a cramp on Tamika Thomas over here in the corner. Joyce Bamasuto is going to take care of that. Probably not a good idea. Should wait till the coach gets there. Tamika Thomas, who put together a string of 6 points, is going to have a little bit of a seat. She either got a little twist on her ankle or...
Yeah, it just looks like she might have fell on it.
So now Fredonia on the floor has Bree Don, who just scored a basket, Rachel Smith, Alice Moore, Naparella back into the game with three fouls, and number 44, Krista Wheelock. Good hustle right there by Naparella again. Nice pass by Rachel Smith. Basket up, no good by Don. Smith with another rebound. Ball in, and put in by number 24, Naparella.
This is the Fredonia basketball that Carol Zirkle likes to coach. Very aggressive, you get that loose ball, they're doing a good job of coming
back.
Well,
they had two hustle plays, one on the sideline and one on the baseline, Mary Kate. And both of them involved Naparella. Naparella gets the rebound.
Carlson picked up her fourth foul, as well as Clark with four.
That's huge fouls. Dunkirk's going to play a long time without their two top rebounders and defenders. And 35-31 lead as Fredonia scored the last five. Mari Massonette in the game. That's a double dribble. Right now, if we know, you can get real aggressive in the middle of the paint offensively. Dunkirk's in a zone. Shot up and no good by Hannah Gilray. Ball out of bounds to Fredonia. Wow. Watch the middle in the out of bounds play. Travel is called.
A little bit of a hesitation move gone wrong.
Nice idea by Smith. One of her few mistakes the entire evening.
Yeah.
She's played a great game.
She's been a big leader for Fredonia. Thomas back in the game with her ankle.
As many freshmen as freshmen and sophomores Fredonia boast, it's the seniors right now that are really putting together a nice game. There's a nice entry pass to Selena Ruiz, and that foul is on number 20, Bree Don. So Selena Ruiz will go to the line. Fredonia's fifth foul of the quarter. Dunkirk has three. Ruiz up, no good. Second shot by Ruiz, up and good. And bringing the ball up is Krista Wheelock, a freshman. There goes Moore driving to the basket. She puts it up and in. A real nice driving shot off, going to the block and putting it up, getting around her defender and putting it in. 36-33, Dunker. Thomas with the ball, bounce pass to Nance. Nance looking to go. There she goes, she puts it up and good. Dee Nance.
Now that girl is a gamer. Yeah. She loves the game.
She puts it up with such ease. Nice shot right there by Alice Moore with a three, closing the gap to 2 points, 2:43 remaining third quarter. And Alice Moore, she just put a couple of nice shots in for Fredonia. It seems like the girls are getting in their own little streak. She's got a 5-point streak. Thomas had a 6-point streak.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's like the girls are getting into streaks,
yeah.
Not the teams. So each girl on the floor is taking charge of their own business here. They're all having a lot of individual game talent we're watching tonight. There's a blocked shot by Moore. So the last minute has been Alice Moore's. Wheelock with the shot, her pass no good. Big rebound by Gilray. And here's where Dunkirk's gonna get in trouble. They don't have any rebounding down there. Fredonia has an opportunity. Dunkirk had a 7-point lead. Fredonia has an opportunity to close the gap and tie the game. That's freshman Krista Wheelock. She plays a little point guard.
Yeah, she does. She's their backup point guard. She's got a good amount to learn, but I feel that in the years coming up, if she continues to play, she could be a really good threat for Fredonia.
Well, as a freshman, she's getting a lot of experience.
Yeah, which is key.
Speaking of key, there she is, Nance with a rebound. She's going to take it on her own, put it up and no good. Let's see who that foul is on. This might be a critical foul.
That's six for Fredonia, so they're going to be in the bonus. Dunkirk, the next foul called.
That foul is on great Alice Moore.
Oh, no, they're in the bonus now.
Well, that'll be a two-shot foul for Nance.
Yeah!
Makes the first one, 39-36. Nance with her second shot. It's up and good. Yeah! Nothing but the bottom of the net. And Dunkirk has a 4-point lead. Here comes Wheelock bringing it up. Over to Smith. Smith with a head fake and a drive. Good idea. She puts it up off the rim. No good. And another offensive rebound. And that is by Wheelock, who's playing point guard. She goes in and crashes the boards.
She's not afraid to get pushed around down there, which is good.
Excellent rebound by Wheelock.
Gotta put these foul shots in now.
Yeah, well.
It's all about concentration.
And this will be, you gotta wonder, you watch Nance just drain too, real easy, a lot
yeah.
of experience. Now you're watching the freshman at the line.
Mm-hmm.
That
right
could be a big factor down the end. Well, she put that one in common. Good shot. 3-point lead by the Lady Marauders. Ari missing it with a head fake and a drive. No good. Here comes Nance. Nance with the ball. She sees Ruiz down low. Good pass. Ruiz fires it up and no good, and she's fouled.
Seems like these refs are a little trigger happy to call some fouls on both teams. Just let the girls play a little bit. You know, it's part of the game to be aggressive.
That foul is on Olivia Pucciarelli, her fourth. Ruiz out on an island with a bunch of white shirts out there shooting foul shots. I've always thought, Mary-Kate, that they should put, when there's a technical foul in the game, I always felt that they should put people there.
Yeah.
Not let people shoot alone. Mm-hmm. I think that's a disadvantage.
I think it is too, because it's
not
kind of
the same.
Yeah. It messes with their mind.
Yeah, because you're alone.
Yeah.
Another nice move by Smith off the glass. Key Nance with another rebound. Rebound, steals, and points. Here comes Bamasuto, head fake. Good entry pass again. Ruiz with the ball. She puts it up, no good. She's shooting flat-footed. A real solid rebound by Moore. Smith over to Wheelock. Oh, Bamasuto with a nice hustle play, causing Wheelock to lose her feet and a travel violation. Here comes Morgan Genovese and Emily Valvo into the game for the Lady Hillbillies. Genovese, I believe, has three fouls. And Emily Valvo gets the distinction of guarding Key Nance. Nance with the ball. Well, they are all over her, and they call a jump. Naparella in for 56 seconds, probably for the offensive rebound.
Yeah.
I wonder if she'll take her out when she's playing D. She's got three fouls.
Come on, Amy.
There goes Valvo moving. How do you travel when you're dribbling?
I know. I think she bobbled a little bit. She's young.
Yeah, but the ref isn't.
I know. Very true. This will be a big offense-defensive play on both teams with the clock winding down.
There's a jump, and Dunkirk retains possession. Shot clock at 23 with 36 remaining in the quarter. Dunkirk has a slim 3-point lead. Now see, smart move by Zirkle. She takes out Naparella with three fouls, so now she's got to play D. She doesn't have it in her game. Nice play by Moore on the steal. Over to Smith. Smith drives it in, no good. Big rebound by 50.
Sarah Kruger
with a big rebound.
Fredonia Ball.
Fredonia Ball with the possession arrow and 23.9 remaining. That was a real nice defensive play the other way by Moore. As Key Nance went around her defender, Moore came and stepped in and
he
stole the ball.
Just called a technical foul. I'm not sure on who. He called the technical foul on Sarah Kruger, a freshman.
Oh, this could hurt.
I wonder what she did to get a technical foul. She's a young freshman girl.
And see, here's that situation. There's nobody around. It's a different situation.
Oh, yeah. Something players got to practice.
That's going to be Dunkirk's ball. That's going to be huge. 23.9. Now, if Nance would have made that one, that would have been a 4-point lead. And she puts that one in a 4-point lead and the ball, Mary Kate.
Yeah, which is a big play. Turnaround for Dunkirk.
That should be Dunkirk's ball, if I'm not mistaken. I'd put Nance right on the foul line, have Masonette dump it into her and let her go, but they don't do that. They're going to give Nance the ball first.
Yeah.
I always told Key, I said, you shouldn't be the point guard. Because when you have the ball, then you pass it, you don't get it back.
Yeah, that's a good
You should be on the foul line, on the wing, so when the point guard gives it to you, now you're the principal scorer. You know, you're the number one scorer of the team.
Or even if she is point guard and set ball screens for her.
Right, exactly. See, they don't have anybody screening for anybody. That's a charge. It's a great steal. First off, it's a great steal by Rachel Smith. You know, then she probably should have waited.
Yeah.
You know, play for the last shot, bring it back out, play for the last shot. Nice charge taken by Nance. Here comes Nance. I clear the floor. There's a screen, but she's got to go to the open area. Double dribble. That's a good call. That's a double dribble. And Fredonia now. So three or four turnovers in the last 20 seconds gives Fredonia the ball back with 5.8 in the last shot.
If I was Smith here, I'd take it to the
Take
home.
It all the way to the basket.
Or give it to her.
It's up and it is. Oh, just off the rim. Off the backboard. Well, the game's getting real spirited, Mary-Kate, and we're going to have a real barn burner going down into this fourth quarter. Game was tied at 23-23, and Dunkirk outscored Fredonia 18-14. So we're going to go into the final quarter of the Dunkirk Lady Marauders and the Fredonia Lady Hillbillies at the Fredonia High School gym, with Dunkirk leading 41-37. How are we doing on the scores, Kate?
Okay, I have for Dunkirk, I have Key Nance with 20 points so far coming into the fourth quarter. Thomas with 8, Ruiz with 3, Clark with 4, and a couple girls with 2, Bamasuto, Carlson, and Masonette. And for Fredonia, I have Smith and Naparella each with 9, Alice Moore, the leading scorer, with 10, Gilray with 4, and Wheelock and Don with 2. Olivia Pucciarelli with a foul shot as well.
Well, I think if you're Fredonia and Dunkirk puts their big girls in, you go hammer them and get them out of the game you play for the last 4 minutes of the game.
If I was Zirkle right now, I'd be pounding the ball into Clark and Carlson and get them into their fifth foul.
And they're on the court. Dunkirk's going to go with their starting five. Bamasuto, Thomas, Nance.
Give the ball to Gilray,
Carlson, and Clark.
Naparella.
And you have Naparella and Gilray down on the block or on the foul line elbows
ready to go down.
Run a little motion. There they are, right at the elbow. Nice pass. Excellent out of bounds. Excellent preparation to come out of the start of the fourth quarter. Good shot by Gilray off the elbow.
This quarter is all about heart for both teams. Which team wants it more?
They have 3 seniors on the floor for Fredonia and 1 senior on the floor for Dunkirk. Nice bounce pass, and there's Moore with another 3. Would have given Fredonia the lead, but Genovese with the rebound, off no good. And there's a rebound by Lacey Clark. Key Nance with the ball, guarded by Wheelock. There goes Lacey Clark, and they're gonna call that an offensive foul, and that's her 5th.
Clark is out of the game for Dunkirk with 7:14 left.
I would say that Lacey Clark unfortunately played about 5 minutes tonight.
Yeah, she had 4 points in the first quarter, and that's it. She hasn't really been an offense or defensive threat because her fouls put her on the bench.
Well, she made a hook move with her left arm. She hooked around.
Mm-hmm. And that was a smart play by Hannah to
fall. There's a steal by Nance and a layup. Boy, she's got Tiger in her. Dunkirk in that zone. They're stopping the elbow that time. There's a nice shot. And a good shot by
Michelle Mapparello.
There we go. I couldn't see it. I was blocking Michelle Mapparello off the elbow. 43-41, 6:40 remaining. Fourth quarter. Key Nance with a jumper. And good. What a shooter. Giving Dunkirk a four-point lead. Bounce pass to Genovese. Genovese drives to the basket. Puts the running one-hander up, no good. And Naparella is there for the rebound, up, no good. And Smith with a rebound, no good. And back over to Gilray, no good. Four consecutive rebounds by the Lady Marauders, or by the Lady Hillbillies, with no points. But again, they are dominating the offensive boards. Key Nance with a drive.
Travel, yeah.
Yeah, good call. Good
call. Very good call by the ref.
She carried that ball into the lane, took an extra step.
And that's a tough play to see, too, because everyone's looking at the basket. You're not sure.
Wheelock with the ball. Genovese with a three.
Now that
Morgan
has some
Genovese.
That's her first points of the game that came out very clutch.
Genovese, Morgan Genovese with a three-pointer. And that closes the gap to one. 45-44, 5:43 remaining, fourth quarter. Dunkirk in the lead. And that was a huge three-pointer by Genovese.
First points of the game, too.
And I know she has been throughout the season. She's been one of Fredonia's more consistent players. But foul trouble tonight.
And Rachel Smith stepped up and played a very good job as point guard, because usually Morgan takes the point guard.
I see.
So.
We've had several individual players tonight really play really, really solid games. Some that you wouldn't expect, and others that you do expect more out of.
Yeah, Alice Forrest hit a couple very good shots today. Thomas has had a great game for Dunkirk so far. But mostly just a Key Nance show right now with 24 points.
24.
24. More than half.
And she's made a ton of different types of shots.
Yeah.
Layups, shots from the corner, shots from the elbow. Off a steal, she's done a number of different things. Dunkirk just doesn't screen. There's a double dribble, but not called. Oh, and there's an over-the-back call on Hannah Gilray. And it looks like Selena Ruiz is gonna get an opportunity to get a lot of points this evening from the foul line. 10 fouls on Fredonia. Dunkirk shoots two the rest of the way. Ruiz, 3 for 4 from the line so far. First one up, and good. Second shot up, and good. Bounces around a little bit, and good. Dunkirk playing another, trying to figure out their defense. Naparella with a nice bounce pass to Wheelock. She traveled. Looked like Dunkirk went into a little man-to-man defense there that time. Into the game for Elena Carlson is number 10, Jessica Gifford. So they're gonna try and space out Elena Carlson and not foul her out right away.
Uh-huh.
Mamasuto with the ball. Driving to her right, that's a no call. Ball goes out of bounds. I think that's what you're talking about, Mary Kate. Let them play a little bit.
Yeah.
Amari Masonette in for Joyce Bamasuto. Masonette, to me, is a little bit more of a conventional ball player. There's a shot by Gilray off the elbow. They're gonna have to protect that, because Gilray has hit one from the right elbow and the left elbow this quarter.
There's not a hand in your face, it's much easier to shoot, and that's what Dunkirk needs to do.
There goes Nance driving, puts it up, no good. Ruiz with a nice rebound. Over to Mosier. Or Gifford, I'm sorry. Gifford with a three off and no good. Yeah, Dunkirk's gonna have to combat the offense of the 1-4 offense of Fredonia if they're gonna be successful the rest of the way. Nance with the ball. Looking for screens, doesn't need any. Now, do we call that ticky-tack?
I'd say so.
You're going to put Nance to the line with a one-point lead, 4:41 remaining, fourth quarter. Now, on the other play, Bamasudo's driving, gets banged around a little bit. The one ref lets him play, and this guy calls that. Nance up and in. She's missed one foul shot?
Yeah, she's 6 for 7 from the line.
Lady Marauders up. Nice drive again by Smith, and another rebound by Naparella.
And this will put Fredoni in the bonus for the
rest
of the game.
Yes, it will. But this is two shots. The thing about Dunkirk is when somebody shoots, they watch the ball. They don't find a player and box out. And they're running into foul trouble because by the time the rebounder gets the ball, Dunkirk's late to react and they push or shove. Elena Carlson back in the game, so they got a minute without her and still held the lead. Naparella puts it up, no good. 2-point lead. Here comes Nance. Carlson with a nice screen. She rolls. There's Tamika Thomas. She's going to let it go from three. Off the mark, Moore with a nice rebound. And here comes Genovese with a nice up-tempo pass over to Smith. Smith with a bounce pass over to Gilray. Driving layup just off the mark. And Nance gets the rebound and she's fouled. That's gonna be two foul shots.
That's when Fredonia's gotta see, okay, Dunkirk has the ball, let's get back. Get some cheap fouls.
That's Rachel Smith's third. Not a problem right now.
Especially Key Nance, you don't want to follow her. She's unstoppable from the foul line right now.
Naparella, nice leadership down there, encouraging all the young ladies from Fredonia. Keep their heads up and keep playing. Nance again. Where do you see her playing, in what position in college, Mary Kate?
No, she's a little short.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna beat around the bush there. I'd see her as a 2.
Yeah.
I couldn't see her as a 3. But girls' sports, it is a little different, so she'd probably be the 2-3. She'd be a very good asset to Madai College, I can tell you that.
You gotta get that coach to come down and give a look.
I will too.
Almost with a steal again, and there's Genovese with her second 3 of the fourth quarter, and she ties the game at 50. Morgan Genovese, clutch shooting 2 threes. And there goes Nance with a drive, and she answers back. It's 52-50. Lady Marauders in the lead, 3:37 remaining, and a travel by Wheelock. Rachel Smith, the senior leader, looks like she's gonna come back into the game. What a shot by Morgan Genovese. Nice arching left-handed shot. And then Key Nance drives the lane and comes back and gets Dunkirk the lead again. Tomasuto looking for that screen. Picks up her dribble, gives the ball over to Gifford. Gifford to Selena Ruiz. And Ruiz is fouled by Moore.
Careful on that, and Dunkirk's waiting for that to happen. They're very good on their foul shots.
Well, we had mentioned that early in the first half, Mary Kate. Fredonia was getting in foul trouble early. They had 10 fouls, 7:49 remaining in the second quarter. Now they're in the same situation. And Dunkirk capitalized early in the second quarter, you know, throughout the second quarter, and they came back as Fredonia took a little bit of a lead. Now, you know, Dunkirk's got to make their foul shots to finish off this game. But, you know, what I like too, though, is that Fredonia's offense, they're getting some real open shots off the elbow, you know, and they're making them.
Yes.
They're hitting them.
And when they don't, they're getting those rebounds.
That's right. You had 2 nice shots off the elbow by Gilray in this quarter, and you've had 2 long shots by Genovese for 3-pointers. And not only, she had 2 hands, she had hands in her face.
Yeah.
She wasn't wide open. She had hands in her face.
Now that's a girl who likes to win and will do anything to win.
Ty Harper walking by.
He was my neighbor when I was younger. He took care of me.
You never know with a smile like that what he's up to. Ruiz makes one of two. And a three-point lead just as we ended the third quarter for Dunker. Going back and forth.
He needs to take some smart
shots. There's that entry pass, and Pat Tyler caught that grab.
Yeah, he did.
You saw it too.
I saw it. And I was going to see maybe they were going to let it go, but can't let that go in a tight game like that.
Grabbed the jersey.
He did. And that's both Clark and Carlson. They're two big defensive rebounding threats, both with five fouls. And done for the game.
I've seen worse fouls, but that was a foul.
Yes. And that's a tough foul.
And I've seen lesser fouls, but that was a foul.
It's a learning lesson for them. They'll both.
Well, that'll bring Naparella to the line. How's she shooting tonight?
She is 4-4-6, it looks like.
The story's been the foul line the whole night.
Yeah.
Up and in on the 1-1. She makes the first one. Closes the gap to two. 3:16 remaining. Naparella's shot up and in. And a one-point lead with 3:16 remaining in the fourth quarter. There goes Key Nance looking for a screen from Ruiz. Clean screen. No shot. She brings it back out over to Gifford. Gifford back to Nance in a hurry. Nance with another nice entry pass. Off the hands of Ruiz. There's a bounce pass by Rachel Smith. Oh, and Ruiz is open, but what great hustle by Alice Moore to intercept that pass. And here comes Genovese. Genovese down the floor, left-handed dribble. Nice bounce pass to Gilray. Gilray up and no good. And the basket's put up and in by Naparella, and Fredonia has the one-point lead. Nance gonna go to the hole and take it herself, and she's fouled. She'll get two.
That's four on Smith now.
But a real nice entry pass. And it to Gilray. Gilray misses the shot, and what we've talked about all night is the offensive rebounds from Naparella. And she's hit the boards, and she put it in and gave Fredonia the lead. Fredonia's first lead of the second half. I think foul shooting down the end here, Mary Kate, is going to be the difference. And the offensive rebounding of Fredonia.
Yes. Coach Zirkle just took out his two seniors. I think she wants to talk to them for getting some water.
Oh, good. Nance misses two consecutive. Rim gets a little smaller late in the game. Dunkirk in a man-to-man. Genovese double-teamed by Nance. Bamasuto, there goes Wheelock. Naparella over to Genovese, she's been hot. Off the rim, no good, and Naparella with a rebound, no good. Bamasuto with the play. Or Gifford, excuse me. Tamika Thomas not paying attention. He didn't have to throw that pass, there was nowhere to go for Thomas. So as much as Fredonia is young, Dunkirk is undermanned because they don't have their two key starters.
Yeah.
So yes, Fredonia is young on the court, but they do have three seniors out on the court.
This is the first time I've seen the Fredonia seniors be big leaders, and it's a really plus for this team. As you can tell, with them being good leaders, they're showing the freshmen that this is how we're supposed to play, and they're doing really well. Morgan just hit two threes.
It's a huge game for Fredonia, the way that, like you're saying, the seniors are just stepping up.
Yes, showing the younger girls, getting them hyped up for the game, and it's really exciting to see. I've been on the edge of my seat this whole game.
Alice Moore with the back hustle on that steal when Ruiz was wide open, and Alice Moore came back and made the steal. You know, and Naparella just bossing the boards. Gilray hitting a couple of shots off the elbow. That's what it takes sometimes, you know. Dunkirk only has one senior in Elena Carlson, and she's been in foul trouble throughout the game. Fredonia really playing with a lot of confidence right now. Here comes Wheelock, making her go left, sliding. Rachel Smith with the ball. They're looking low to Naparella. She drives, she shoots, and a travel. Into the game will be Emily Valvo. So she's gonna mix and match for Rachel Smith so she doesn't commit another foul. But I'll tell you, Valvo is gonna be playing Key Nance. Ball into Nance, almost stolen by Valvo. Thomas with the ball.
Valvo's very aggressive. Look at her. She is not letting it push her around.
Oh, they just bumped heads. Down into Nance. She's got lane. You're right, Mary Kate. She just played her as hard as anybody could. Absolutely.
She's not afraid to be pushed around, which is great.
Nice move by Coach Zirkle there to not have Rachel Smith playing her and playing D, because Rachel Smith has four, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
Now Dunkirk needs to think the other way. If Rachel Smith comes in the game and they don't get a timeout or there's not a chance, you have to go after her. You have to identify. Well, there's Key Nance, who's missed her last three foul shots. You have to have a coaching staff on the sideline identifying who has fouls and who doesn't, mm-hmm. and who you need to attack.
Oh, my game.
That's a shooter's bounce right there. And here comes Genovese, 54 all. Genovese with another three-pointer. And the freshman hits her third three-pointer of the fourth quarter, giving Fredonia a three-point lead. Morgan Genovese, left-handed shot. Thomas down to Nance. Nance gonna turn, put it up and in. And Nance responds with a turnaround jumper from down about 7-8 feet, and she'll go to the line.
That was a well-played defense by Fredonia. I'm not sure if that was a foul, but.
And who's that foul on? That foul is on Naparella. That's her fourth. Boy, you got a man up or girl up on Genovese coming down the court. She's launching. Nance puts it up, and it's a tie ball game. 103 remaining. What a great game we've had here tonight. Here comes Genovese, she's a lefty. Almost stolen by Bamasuto. Here's Gilray with the ball over to Rachel Smith. 55 seconds remaining, tie ball game. There's Genovese, oh, she let her go. And it's Gilray for three, in and out. Oh, it just rolls out. It rattled in, it rattled out.
Someone kicked it out.
42 seconds remaining and a timeout by Carol Zirkle. Tie ball game.
Big thing for Fredonia right now is not to foul.
I think you're right. Foul. They have 10 fouls.
Lean into them, make them foul.
Two big girls, big nights tonight for Fredonia. Rachel Smith and Naparella still on the floor. You have to identify that, Mary Kate, and attack them. Maybe they'll let somebody go by them a little bit. Fredonia's gonna need back help because you know that ball's going to Nance.
Uh-huh.
Somehow, some way, that ball's gonna get into Nance. How many does she have this evening?
You know, I gotta count.
She had 25 somewhere along the line. I think she's over 30 tonight.
I have 33.
33 points by Key Nance. Outstanding shooting display, inside, outside. Now she's gonna be asked again. Is that Fredonia's ball? I thought that was Dunkirk, but it's Fredonia's ball.
Oh no, it's Dunkirk's. I think he pointed this way.
Yeah, because Fredonia lined up like it was their ball.
the tension in
here. Oh, yeah.
Everyone's on the edge of their seat.
For the good, for the bad, or for the indifferent?
Definitely.
It's been a great game.
It has.
You know, I mean, it was a 12-11 lead after one quarter by Fredonia, a 23-23 tie, and then it was a three-point lead after three quarters by Dunkirk, and Fredonia's battled back. Three straight three-pointers by Morgan Genovese, a couple of hit baskets by Gilray, you know, and Naparella bossing them boards, and Fredonia came right back at it.
This quarter.
What can you say about Key Nance, though?
She's
done it all.
She has. She is a pleasure to watch, and I would love to play with her, that's for sure.
And these complimentary players from Dunkirk have really come in, and they've maintained, you know, I mean, Fredonia's played very, very hard, but when Carlson and Lacey Clark have not been in the game, players like Ruiz and Gifford and Damari Massanet have really stepped up. Well, here goes Nance. They're going to watch her. 30 seconds left. Here goes Nance. No call. She's out of bounds. Nope. She loses the ball. And here comes Genovese. She's going to put it up and no good. And the rebound goes to Joyce Bamasuto. And it's a tie-up. And the ball, the possession arrow, goes to the Lady Marauders.
Off the clock.
15 seconds remaining. Now here's the thing. Does Fredonia put a little pressure on Mary Kate because they could take the chance of fouling?
That's very true. It's one of those tough calls, I think.
Well, she's going to put pressure on her.
I think they should be denying.
Get it back. Get it back to the money. Get the ball back to the money. Yep.
If I was her, I would put two people on Key Nance to not let her touch the ball. Take that risk. Not many other players have made tough shots at the end of the game. And if she wants to shoot over two people, let her.
The only player in the fourth quarter that has scored for Dunkirk, other than Key Nance, is Selena Ruiz, and that's been at the foul line. You had a little glimmer of hope when Tamika Thomas made six straight points in the third quarter. But other than that, you know, Dunkirk doesn't have any other offensive firepower with Clark and Carlson out of the game. This will be interesting. They're going to be all over Key Nance. Well, you got to set some screens for that young lady for her to get open.
Definitely. By the way she's playing, I'd give her the ball too.
Would you have her take it out and then get it back to her, or you just try and get her open?
You know what? I think I would, actually. Have her give the ball and set a back screen for her.
You know how many times in a basketball game the person who takes the ball out is the person who ends up open.
Yeah, happens all the time.
We'll see how Coach Sarah Bogardis in her first Dunkirk-Fredonia game as a Dunkirk coach handles it. Yep, she's going to have her take it out. Don't put the ball in the backcourt, correct?
Yes, no.
Don't throw the ball backwards, and they do. You got to get it back to her. And she has it. Here goes Nance. It's up and it's, oh, just off the rim. They got the shot they wanted. And Nance puts the ball up and it bounced three times on the rim. And we are going into overtime. Wow, they got the shot they wanted. I was concerned when they put the ball in the backcourt that was going to be a huge problem, but they got it forward. Joyce Bamasuto did the right thing, moved it up the court, got it to Nance. They got the shot they wanted. So we are going into a four-minute overtime. And with that missed shot, I would say that Fredonia is going to start this overtime with some momentum. But, again, you have these other things going on with Rachel Smith now and Naparella with the foul shot. So look to Gilray to be their offensive threat, as well as who? Morgan Genovese, who's had 3 three-pointers in the fourth quarter. And Nance has how many in that quarter?
In the fourth quarter alone, Key Nance had 13 points.
13 points in the fourth. Wouldn't have been appropriate if she would have ended the game on a little bit of a jumper. But we got 4 more minutes of exciting basketball here at the Fredonia High School Gymnasium. The Fredonia Lady Hillbillies and the Dunkirk Lady Marauders are hooked up in a doozy.
And expect nothing less of a Dunkirk-Fredonia game.
No, not at all. In fact, this has been something more. I haven't seen Alice Moore in the game lately. She's an offensive threat as well. What energy. Naparella, Keen Nance, Rachel Smith, those three girls tonight. Oh, Ruiz gonna take one herself. No good. Wheelock with the rebound. Bringing it up to Genovese. You got a garter. Nice head fake and move by Gilray. Ball up and in. And that gives Fredonia a two-point lead. They strike first in overtime, 3:35 remaining. Here goes Nance, nobody guarding her, and she's gonna put it up, and in, she answers back.
She will go post to post no matter what.
She's just going on her own, but the thing about it is, Rachel Smith's in the middle, Naparella's in the middle, they're not gonna guard her.
Yeah.
But Naparella did pick up the foul, Mary-Kate, I'm surprised, I didn't see that.
That's her fifth.
So Key Nance gets her 35th point, looking for 36. I'm kind of thinking that.
That's a huge letdown for.
I'm kind of thinking there might be a school record involved here with 36. I'm not quite sure. They now want to replace the player, and by rule, you get a minute to do it.
Most fans don't know most of the basketball rules.
No.
They're allowed to yell.
I think that's a good choice by Coach Zirkle putting in Alice Moore. And here comes Nance looking to put Dunkirk in the lead. I believe Karen Grace, Dunkirk's all-time leading scorer. I'm not quite sure what her point total was in a game. But it's got to be close to 36. There's Genovese with a head fake. She's going up again. Off the rim, no good. Wheelock with the rebound, no good. Ruiz tips it away, and it comes down to Bamasuto. Bamasuto bringing it up. No one on Gifford yet. There we go. Bamasuto with the ball to Tamika Thomas. Nance with another shot up, no good.
Call something there.
Hey, there's a foul.
I'm not sure out of all the things that were happening down there, I'd call a foul. With some travels.
Of course, I'm getting stuff from the sideline at the point totals.
Fifth foul, she's out as well.
She's out as well. I'm getting stuff from the sideline that I think it's Bridget Henderson who had over 40 points in the game.
40,
so
oh,
I'll
wow.
stand corrected, but I'll tell you what, Key Nance is
she's
on her way.
She's getting pretty close.
She's getting close.
2:45 still left. Well,
here's Key Nance. 36, Mary-Kate?
Yeah.
She has a chance for two more, but not more importantly, she has a chance to put Dunkel up in overtime with 2:45 remaining. Shot up, no good.
I think she has 35. This will be a 36 okay. point. Let me check one more time.
Now I'm getting more reports from Jim Jefferson that Karen Grace's record was 41. Nance, steady at the line all night, puts it up and in, giving Dunkirk a one-point lead, the narrowest of margins as this game has been throughout. Rachel Smith with the ball. Here goes Genovese, another head fake and a drive. Off the rim, no good. Rebound put up by there, and it's foul on Nance. So we'll see Genovese at the foul line for the first time. So the freshman, we'll see how she responds. She's responded by 3 three-pointers. Let's see how she does at the line. Fortunately enough for Dunkirk, that is only Keenance's only third foul. First one up and good.
Beautiful confidence by her. As a freshman, that's a great thing to see.
Nice shot by a lefty. I got a soft spot for lefties. That's a nice shot. Ball up and good. 11 points for Genovese, all in the fourth quarter and overtime. Nobody guarding Nance. She's going to go in, take it coast to coast, and put it back in and give Dunkirk a one-point lead. What a game. There's Genovese. They got to identify she's left-handed. Up, no good. Ruiz with a rebound. Slow it down. Don't throw it up the court. Oh, turnover by Nance. Here comes Genovese. Genovese driving the lane and puts it up and in. And Zirkle takes a timeout. Genovese, 4 points in the overtime. 9 points in the fourth quarter. 63-62 Fredonia. 1:56 remaining.
That was a smart play by Fredonia down here, doubling Nance, making her throw the bad pass to one of her teammates.
It's like you said before they took the ball out of bounds. With 10 seconds left, Mary Kate, double team Nance, let everybody else play the game. See what somebody else can do. You have to force Dunkirk to play basketball. You have to force the other gals to play.
I'm surprised that Carol Zirkle didn't do more of a box and one on Keen Nance. I mean, it's tough. She's so good, she gets open even with face guards, so.
Yes, she does. Some clutch shooting on both ends, one by Keen Nance, but the rest of the Fredonia Lady Hillbillies have made some outstanding shots. You couldn't ask for a more exciting basketball game to start the Fredonia Dunkirk series this year. Somebody's going to be open because they're going to guard Nance. I like Fredonia's matchup. They put Rachel Smith on Tamika. And now they're going to put Velvo on Keen Nance. And as you said, they guard her tough.
They are double teaming her.
Oh, yeah. Anywhere she goes.
Look at her, pushing her around.
Wow, what a shot. Fredonia ball on a jump ball violation. Nance is doing anything she can to shoot. Great job by Emily Velvo to harass Nance. They're in and out again. Pucciarelli in for Velvo. There's Grace Smith, picks up the dribble, and here comes Genovese. You need to identify she's left-handed. Pucciarelli with a big rebound. And off the rim, and she'll go to the line. I think they need to identify Morgan Genovese is left-handed.
Yeah.
She makes the little head fake, drives
always
to the left.
Yep.
Make her go to the right. 1 point lead. Pucciarelli up and just off the mark. 1:17 remaining in overtime.
This is a big basket by Pucciarelli.
Mari Massonette in for Guilford. Jessica Guilford, just a sophomore. Here's Pucciarelli looking for a two-point lead. Ball's up and no good. Violation, doesn't hit a thing. Now, doesn't the ball go on the side?
Yeah. I don't know.
Not in high school?
I don't think we do that.
Okay. Nance over to Ruiz. Know your role. Don't shoot. Nice entry pass. Nance got four around her. Kicks it out to Massonette. Messing that up, no good. And the ball goes out of bounds. Well, you could see from the start she didn't want to take that shot.
Yeah, definitely, she was nervous.
Here comes Fredonia, work a little clock, you got a lead. Smith gets by. It's a charge on Smith. That's her fifth foul. Selena Ruiz stood her ground in the middle and took the charge.
This is when I hope we had replay to check that out.
Rachel Smith driving to the basket as she's been successful all night is called for that charge. like to see a lot of these on replay.
No, for sure. That was a perfect play by Fredonia, too. No one was in health defense. Three girls were up. She made the right pass. Unfortunately, guards weren't in her.
Everybody her came up. Nobody was back.
Yeah.
Well, we know where Dunkirk's going. Now we got to watch how Fredonia brings the ball up. And, well, as you said before, Morgan Genovese plays the point.
Yes.
So this will be her time.
It is. And Emily Valvo's been playing great defense on Keenan. She's got to keep pushing her around. They're not going to call a foul on her unless the ball's into her. So
right.
Keep pushing her. Taking offensive charge on Nance.
Right now you got Gilray, the senior, guarding Nance. Oh, she picked the dribble up. Three seconds.
She was in there for a long
time.
She was in there a long time.
Well, I would say she was in there. There was 48 seconds, 39. She's probably in there for five or six seconds. But do you call that now? They didn't call it all night.
It's very true. It's one of those things they call always at the wrong times.
Oh, Velvo with the ball. Here goes Genovese. She's going to let it go. Off the rim, no good. Big rebound by Valvo. Standing wide open is Gilray, and it gives Fredonia a three-point lead with 20 seconds left. Bamasuto going in, a timeout is called.
What a great offensive rebound by Hannah. She
she's standing all
position.
Alone.
Yeah.
She was right in position.
That's when they need Clark and Carlson down there. They've been fouled out for quite some time now. Now, Dunkirk only has one girl with a three, so I'm thinking they'll hopefully drive someone in, get a quick two, and foul.
Absolutely correct. You get a quick two, let them take the ball out, try and foul them. It's a lot of standing around again when the girls, when some of the girls haven't had the experience of playing as much and getting the minutes, you know, in these games, there's a lot of standing around, and that's what happened. The shot went up, and Gilray was just standing on the bottom block, wide
place,
open.
Right time.
She went to an open area. Gilray, 8 points in the second half, four in the fourth quarter, and four in the overtime. Nance going to take the ball out. Let's see how Dunkirk needs to go that way.
Yes.
Here comes Thomas. They need to get it to Nance in a hurry. Gifford with the ball. Ruiz, Gifford's got to shoot. Somebody's got to shoot. And that ball is off of someone, and it's Dunkirk's ball. If you had another timeout, you should use it. Watch Nance as she takes the ball out. Ball back to Nance on the screen. No shot, 1.2 left.
What a great deflection by Hannah Gilray.
Excellent, stepping into the passing lane.
Fredonia runs the same play that Dunkirk's doing, so they know it. They know what they're gonna do.
With that person taking the ball out, it's gonna get the shot. There's a shot up and no good. And Fredonia with a huge win over the Lady Marauders, their first win of the season in overtime fashion, 65-62. What an outstanding basketball game, Mary Kate.
Might one of the best Dunkirk Fredonia games I've ever witnessed.
In many,
just
many years.
Incredible play by both teams.
In many, many years.
Take that away from her, even with the loss.
You can't take that effort away. Yeah, I think there's a couple of different things that happened tonight, Mary Kate. I think that I thought Fredonia's seniors were really stepped up tonight for the Lady Hillbillies. I thought that they played an excellent game. I thought the game plan for Fredonia early, being physical, up on top and forcing Dunkirk guards other than Nance to do something with the ball. I thought that was a great part of the game plan.
And a huge thing was for Morgan Genovese to come up with 13 points in the fourth quarter in overtime. She didn't have anything in the first, second, third, and to come out with three threes in the fourth quarter.
The fourth quarter.
It's just incredible.
Outstanding shooting by a freshman. And then she stepped to the line in overtime and drains two more. And again, what an outstanding effort for everybody. Just an outstanding basketball game. Unfortunately, Dunkirk, you know, they had to play without their two gals. They have a short bench. They only had, eight girls dress. So they had a short bench. And without Carlson and Lacey Clark, their two inside rebounders, it was obvious where Fredonia was going with the ball and how much success Fredonia was going to get in the middle. And it's exactly what transpired throughout the whole game.
It would have been a totally different ball game with Carlson and Clark in there, but Fredonia took advantage and they pulled out a victory.
They did. They took. It's exactly what you're saying. They took advantage of Dunkirk's weaknesses throughout the game. The game was very, very close, you know, throughout. 12-11 Fredonia after one, 23-23 at the half. A three-point lead by Dunkirk going into the fourth quarter. And then Fredonia outscored Dunkirk by three, and then the final score. So, Mary Kate, what do we have as scorers?
For Dunkirk, we have Keen Nance with 38 points. Thomas with 8, West with 6, Clark with 4, and a couple girls with 2. Mamasuto, Carlson, and Nance. For Fredonia, we have Genovese with 13, Naparello with 13, Gilray with 12, Ellis Moore with 9, Smith with 9, Wheelock with 2, Breedon with 2, and Olivia Pucciarelli with 1.
Well, Mary Kate, that's the first game of the night. It was a barn burner, as they say, the old cliche. Dunkirk Fredonia boys games, always good games. You know, they got similar records. Well, Dunkirk has a 7-1 lead or 7-1 overall record. Fredonia's a little bit hovering around 500. But you know, this is going to be a great game.
Like I always say, it doesn't matter. It's Dunkirk Fredonia.
So we're going to turn this over to Coach Ed Eaker. Thank you for joining us, and there's 14 minutes, 20 seconds before the start of the Dunkirk Fredonia boys tip-off. Thank you.